The river cruise brought me a taste of one of Tagum's indigenous tribes. But apparently, that was just the beginning. An edible adventure of ethnic Mindanao awaits. Lani Santa Maria may be known as Iho's operations head for leisure and tourism, but I prefer to call her by her other title, a walking encyclopedia of Tagum culture and food. Think I'm kidding? Lani invites me for lunch and tells me to prepare to taste traditional southern dishes. She was not kidding. This spread from the menu of the plantation house is curated by Lani herself and executed by Chef Charlie. Every single dish on this table is unfamiliar and completely Filipino. I am loving it. I start with this dish, a cornucopia of colors and a most interesting topping.
You roast the coconuts, grated coconut, and then you add some chili and dried salted fish.
Wow, definitely something you need to try.
A bagobo dish. They call it sinara.
Sorry?
Sinara.
Sinara.
Yeah.
Like closing?
Yes.
Close? Sinara. Okay. Here you go, Miss Lani.
Thank you. Is it nice?
Wow. Okay. I gotta tell you, that's an experience.
Yeah.
Sinara was just the opening chapter of a great ethnic culinary tour of Mindanao.
So this one is a tiboli dish.
Tiboli, okay.
Yeah, they call it uton sinabaw.
And is it beef or it looks
beef.
Like beef?
Right? It's beef.
Ooh.
And you just have to boil it and simmer it with simple spices.
Okay.
Just ginger and onions and this one, the
lemongrass.
Lemongrass.
Ginger, onions, lemongrass, and beef.
Yeah.
Wow, okay. Usually when I cook lemongrass, it's usually with fish or chicken, not really with beef. Wow, beef is super tender. These are really subtle, like...
And it's so natural.
Yeah, ginger, lemongrass, very strong flavors, but when you take it in, it's very, very subtle, very, very light. So even if it's a beef soup, right? You can drink more of it, right? All right, the chicken.
Yeah, okay. Try this.
I think the chicken has a very interesting name. Mm-hmm. It's called...
Linotlot na mano.
Linotlot.
Okay, this so is... does that mean anything, lotlot, or... what?
I think because it's cooked in bamboo. So it's braised chicken in a bamboo.
Nice. Hopefully, you know, when you cook it inside of a fresh bamboo stem, you can pick up maybe a little bit of that hint of fresh bamboo with your chicken, right? But this is native chicken, right? You can tell almost immediately if you use native chicken. Mm-hmm. Like, it's just so much flavor in the broth. What did you put in there? I mean, there's lemongrass.
Just lemongrass. Mm-hmm. You see, they have common ingredients.
Yeah.
The natives use common ingredients, those that they can pick in their backyard.
Right, again.
So they have lemongrass, native onion leaves, and... ginger.
Right, so you're
plus the coconut cream, the cocoa milk.
Oh, just coconut milk inside.
Yeah.
Okay, I didn't even taste the heaviness of the cream, right? It's very, very light.
The Calagans make another appearance at the table, this time in a rice dish.
This is their version of risotto.
Uh-huh.
This is turmeric rice, actually.
Oh,
but
nice.
They call it sinagapuna.
Sinagapuna.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That's definitely more interesting than saying risotto, if you ask me.
Sinagapuna, it goes well with everything, including this specialty from the Manobo tribe.
They call it binunguhan nga nukos. Nukos is squid.
Ah, the nukos. Okay.
So they normally wrap that. They wrapped it with banana leaves before they grill it.
Oh, nice. Nice, nice.
So what else
just tomatoes and onions.
Green onions,
and,
right?
Yeah, again, lemongrass.
Squid is nicely cooked, like really tender. Sometimes, you know, you can over-grill squid. Kind of gets rubbery. This one's perfect. maybe the banana leaves help protect it as well.
Beautiful. To keep the moisture. If you still have some space, you have to try the cassava.
Cassava?
Yeah, okay. they call it Linotlot Quinada.
Linotlot.
So it's like
Quinada.
Our cassava cake.
Okay.
You should try it.
So does that mean if it's Linotlot, it's also cooked in bamboo?
Cooked in bamboo.
Right. Wow, look at that. All right, I'm going to try this. And it's nice and sticky, as you would expect from a cassava. Now, a lot of this dish is about the texture. I mean, every time you eat cassava, it's really about the texture of the dish. You know, nice and chewy. And just a hint of that cocoa syrup. You know, cocoa syrup can be very intense, but this one, I think it goes perfectly with it because it's just on the outside. If you take a look at the cassava in the middle, it's still pretty pure, so it's a perfect balance. It's good.
If you think for a second this is one of those we'll read books and make our own version of their food type of deal, think again. Lani personally learned these recipes from the different ethnic groups. Her passion for Mindanao's rich culinary traditions comes through with each bite. Now that is good eating.